Good morning, listeners. I greet you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This morning's sermon, faith is not blind. This is a very awkward subject for a sermon, but later on you'll see the reason for this name. Faith is not blind. But first we had to go to the Word of God to see what is faith all about. Romans 10, 17 says the following. So then, faith comes by hearing, and the hearing by the Word of God. This is very important to understand where faith comes from. You have to study the Word, meditate on the Word, to hear God's voice. Even to hear God's promises for you. Today we are going to hear about a promise what God made to the Israelites concerning the promised land. First, when the Lord spoke to Moses in Exodus 3 verse 8. So I have come down to deliver them out of the land of the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up from the land to a good and large land, to a land flowing with milk and honey, to the place of the Canaanites, Hittites, the Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. So God make a promise to Moses. And today we're going to hear what happened in the land of milk and honey. In Numbers 13, 1 to 33, we're not going to read all the verses, certain verses are going to be highlighted. But we're going to read from verse 1 until 3. Numbers 13, verse 1 to 3. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, send men to spy out the land of Canaan, which I am giving to the children of Israel. Did you hear? It's a promise. God said, which I'm giving to the children of Israel. From each tribe of their fathers you shall send a man, everyone a leader among them. So Moses sent them from the wilderness of Paran according to the command of the Lord. All of them men who were heads of the children of Israel. They were leaders, and among those 12 was Caleb and Joshua. So Moses appointed 12 leaders from the tribes of Israel. But before he sent them out, there was a certain instructions. And we're going to read that in verse 17. Then Moses sent them to spy out the land of Canaan and said to them, go up to this way into the south and go up to the mountains and see what the land is like, whether the people are dwelt in it are strong or weak, few or many. Verse 19, whether the land they dwell is a good or bad, where the cities are inhabited are like camps or strongholds, whether the land is rich or poor, and whatever they are, forest or not, be of good courage and bring some of the fruits of the land. Now the time of the season of the first ripe grapes. And I would like you to take note of God's timing at this stage. Did you hear what the word says in verse 20? Now the time was the season of the first ripe grapes. So God's planning is 100% to make sure for what the spies are going to see, it is real, a good land, a land of milk and honey. Now the report comes. Verse 27 and 29. When they told them to, and said, we went to the land where you sent us, it literally flows with milk and honey. And this is its fruit. The cluster of that grapes was so big, it had to be carried between two men. I've never seen such a cluster in my life. I don't know if my friends from the Cape have ever seen it, but from my side, I've never seen it. But the 12 spies that went out, the leaders, they saw that. Verse 28. Nevertheless, the people who dwell in the land are strong. The cities are fortified with and very large. Moreover, we saw the descendants of Anak there. And Anak is the descendants of, and that was giants. They were huge. So they saw them. They were there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, the Hebrites and the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the mountains, and the Canaanites dwell in this, by the sea along the bank of the Jordan. Next you'll see what is this sermon's theme all about. We've got people that is faith that's not blind, and then we've got people faith that is blind. Take note of the following. Verse 30. Then Caleb quote the people before Moses and said, "Let us go up at once and take position, for we are well able to overcome it." Caleb was not blind. His faith is in God. He saw the giants. They were there. The cities were big. There were many people. But listen to what he said. We are well able to overcome it. So his faith was not blind. He had faith in God, because he bore in mind that God says, it will be a land that I'm giving to you. So that was a promise. But next, listen to this. And then comes the but. You know, when there's something to be done, but there's a but, then you know it's going to be negative. And this is where the faith comes in that is blind. Verse 31. But the men who had gone up with them said, "We are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we." Did you hear that? This is the person, there's 10 of them. Their faith was blind. They didn't have any faith in the promise of God, which he said, "I'm giving it up to you." And here is the defendants of people who are not standing on the promise of God and have no faith in God, who is promised, who is a promise keeper. Have you ever listened to that song, "The Waymaker"? He's a promise keeper. Our God is a promise keeper. My dear listener, do you still stand on the promises of God for you? Are you still have faith in the promises of God? The Word of God is true and is alive. Don't look at the giants. Look at the promise. Look up at God, who is the promise keeper. You need to stand on God's word, and you need to stand on God's promise. I want to give you a verse that's very, very important. God invites you and me to remind him of the promise that he's given to us. We've seen it in Isaiah 62, verse 6 and 7. I'm going to read it to you. "I have set watchmen on the walls of Jerusalem. They shall never hold their peace day and night. You who make mention, remind, of the Lord, do not keep silent. I give him no rest till he is established, and till he makes Jerusalem a praise in the earth." And give him no rest till he establishes. This is it, stands in verse 7. Did you hear? You need to remind God of his promises for you. Are you still standing on it? Do you still have faith in the promise of God? And I want to close the sermon this morning with a promise from God. And this promise is appropriate to the season that we are living in now in South Africa, even in the world. But let's talk about South Africa. It's our land, our country, it's our people. Listen to Psalm 91 from verse 1. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Did you hear that? He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I will trust. This is somebody that has faith that is not blind. Surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the pestilence. Verse 4, He shall cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. Verse 5, You shall not be afraid of the terror that by night, nor by the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Listen to verse 8, 9, and 10. Only with your eyes you shall look and see the reward of the wicked. Verse 9. Because you have made the Lord, who is your refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. And here, verse 10. Listen to this. This is faith, not blind. No evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. Isn't it relevant in our days now that we need to stand on God's promise and to remind Him, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling place. We need to stand on God's promises. We need to remind Him of His promises. And the key words in verse 2 says, in Him I will trust. Dear listener, we trust that the Holy Spirit will encourage you to study God's word, to study His word every day, day and night, to meditate on His promises for you. You've got an invitation from the Lord this morning to remind Him of His promises for you. We pray that you still have promises from God. If not, my friend, you need to go and study God's word to see what's God's promises for you. Look at Psalm 91 as an example of promises for you. Have faith that is not blind, but be open-minded to the promises of the Lord, of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. Let us pray. Lord, thank you very much for your word this morning. Thank you that we can stand on your promises. Thank you that your word invites us to study Psalm 91, where it says, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling place. Lord, we remind you of this promise. And we pray that each and every listener this morning will take it at heart and know that you are a promise keeper. We pray this in the lovely name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.